finally got around to playing with my snapper again. decided that last video that I did showing how to adjust your cables for your clutch brake and your auxiliary brake. I was pretty disgusted at how greasy that was. So, it's about as clean as this old bugger is going to get. There's no grease anywhere. Maybe little bits that I missed here and there, but I'm certainly not going to cry about it. I'm going to need a new brake band for the auxiliary brake, but I'm not going to really bother with it right now because I'm thinking of turning that pedal into a throttle pedal regardless, so I don't think I'm going to worry about it. Now that all the grease is gone, though, I now know why I had auxiliary brake issues. Because now I can see. Where's my screwdriver so I can point this out? Right there is the tab that holds your cable in. It's kind of like. Where? Can I get over there? Where is it? That's in the dark. There. It should be looking like that. Curved up so it doesn't slip out when it's slack. But this one is all bent downwards. So that explains why I had excessive slack in my auxiliary brakes. And I'll fix that up by taking a few of those floating nubby things out. Give myself some slack. I'll bend that back up with a pair of needle noses or something. Just kind of flip them up. Put the cable back in it. And that'll fix that up. I'm going to do a video for bleached PC on how to change the brake lever here. So I'm just going to take mine apart and put it back together. And that'll help him out, and maybe you too. I am going to get a new, they call it a driven wheel, because this one's obviously pooched. But I can order them from Sears. And there's a little Sears order place down in town there that I can just order it over, and it's $6.32 for the whole driven wheel. So, can't argue with that. And give you a different look, because my motor's out. Might be a lot of backlighting though. That's the top of the brake lever there. And it sits on, I guess, your selector. When you're going into reverse, you're coming up into here. And then when you're first, second, third, fourth, fifth, it slides along there. And your brake sits on that, so when it moves up, because when you put the clutch down and your brake, this hole, can I reach it? That hole, see how it comes up? So that's what activates the brake. It pushes down on that. Plus it's taking the wheel off of the drive plate that would normally be right here. So there's a look at a pretty clean snapper. And I'm probably not going to bother painting it until I get a new driven wheel and everything. Who knows when that's going to be. Like I say, this is a real big time back burner project, so I will try to get her done in some sort of timely fashion, but it's not the top of my list right now. Anyway, ciao for now. I'll get ready to do that other video. I'm going to get the frog out of my throat first of all. I'm going to put some WD-40. Because I'm thinking, I never changed one before, but I'm thinking you can either take the whole hub off, which could be a pain in the arse, Or you could just take the driven wheel off with its three little bolts, and that'll give you enough room on this side to be able to pull the brake lever out. Because with the, I guess, drum side here, there'd be no room to slide that out. Once that's gone, you've got to the top of that pedal there. So you should be able to just slide it on, slide it off. It's only one bolt down here with a nut. I used a pair of needle nose, and bent those tabs back up. And I also squished them together a little bit, just to make sure that nibby doesn't come out again. Auxiliary brakes working fine. I readjusted the cable, and it's good to go. Except for the fact that I need a new band, but as I say, I'm probably changing that to a throttle anyway, so it doesn't matter. Ciao for now.